bid you all welcome on this fourth Sunday of Lent, one of the final legs of our Lenten journey together. Before I forget, as a reminder, I'll be away next Sunday, so there will be no contemplative service next Sunday evening. We will reconvene on Palm Sunday evening and then follow through our regular Holy Week rotation of services. So I invite you now to consider the journey we have been on together, to consider the journey of these 40 days of Lent, of this period of reflection and challenge. And I invite you now to enter into this evening's worship through our responsive call to worship. Have you not known?
My God is the everlasting God, creator of the ends of the earth.
Have you not heard?
God does not faint or grow weary.
Have you not known?
God's understanding is unsearchable.
Have you not heard?
God gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless.
Have you not known?
Those who wait for God will renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles.
We come to hear.
We come to know. Thanks be to God.
Our first hymn this evening is number 554 in your hymnals. Abide with me, fast falls the eventide.
Oh,
God of relationship, God of Trinity, you flow through everything and you flow through us. Relationships are complicated, and your relationship with us is no different. Be with us this week as we embrace the things we struggle to understand and strive to carry on in relationship with you, even without all the answers. Help us to trust in you and in the promises you have made. Amen. I invite you now to join me in the responsive prayer printed into your bulletin. Creator God, create in our hearts a trust for you and for your promises. Create in us a love for you and for all of your creation.
Help us to trust in our relationship with God.
Jesus, you often spoke in stories that were confusing to the people who listened to them. Help us to trust in the truth of your love for us and for all people.
Help us to trust in our relationship with God.
Spirit of God, inspire us to action, even when we don't have all the answers. Help us to help others, even when we don't have all the tools. We have much to learn. Teach us to trust you.
Help us to trust in our relationship with God.
Sue.
Our scripture lesson this evening comes in two parts. The first from the book of Numbers, and the second from the Gospel of John. And the Lord said to Moses, "Make a poisonous serpent and set it on a pole, and everyone who is bitten shall look at it and live." So Moses made a serpent of bronze and put it on a pole, and whenever a serpent bit someone, that person would look at the serpent of bronze and live. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Present us with a contradiction. For the story of the Israelites we hear in the book of Numbers, Moses is told by God on high to make an image. The same God who told him, "You shall have no other gods before me," and also that you shall make no graven images. But we have this snake. And later we hear from John, who as a gospel writer was not particularly concerned with the ins and outs of Israelite religion, seeing instead Jesus as a new creature, ascribing to him a new beginning. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God. But John goes out of his way to call back to this obscure and confusing episode. Faced with this contradiction, we are forced to accept that some of God's ways are outside of our understanding. So the question this evening becomes, can we see God working in situations that confuse us? Results on our schedule, comfort now, satisfaction of prayer now. We wish for something more, something different than what we are being offered. We want someone to solve the problems that we ourselves had a hand in creating. And so, we build idols. Foolish ways, our thoughtless words, our arrogant ignorance, preferring instead to offer our attention to them rather than those monsters that lie beneath, those hard questions, that sense that maybe our trust in God is leading us to some place we might be afraid to go. So may we turn our eyes once again during this Lenten season, to the God of the journey, the God of this Lent, who asks that we focus our hearts on his way, that we may be faithful to those promises. What idols do we raise up in our day-to-day lives? carpenter, friend of fishermen. Look upon him and live. Equally as unlikely to those who expected God to be acting in one way which conforms to their wisdom, to the wisdom of the world. But friends, believe this. God so loved the world. God loves the world. In God's world, we are all called beloved. So may the truth of this great love story shine through our worship this evening and renew our sense of calling. So despite our tiredness and frustration and discouragement, all of the things which wear us down on our journey, our doubts, our fears, our longings, tonight may we discover yet again how Jesus reveals God's love and God's mercy. Friendship to God, in friendship to each other, and in friendship to the world, to listen to God's word for us, one which is being offered in ways that confound our understanding sometimes. So tonight, in what ways are we listening to this message? In what ways lifting Jesus up? Lord, we confess that our hearts are hardened, that we prefer to choose certainty over this confusing faith. In our lives, we often choose anxiety over courage, independence over compassion. We turn our eyes from our neighbors in need and from stories of despair or pleas for peace or from anything that might bring tears to our eyes. For all too often, we prefer our own comfort. We get caught up in our own needs and desires and forget that you have made us to be your people together. So engrave your word on our hard hearts again, O Lord, and break them open. For what breaks your heart? That your word might sink in and become part of us, so that we might truly live as your beloved. So that we might truly live as if you are our God and we your people. Amen. Our closing hymn this evening is number 378. Lord, speak to me that I may speak. Thank you. prepare to part. May God bless us when we walk humbly. May God bless us when we don't have all of the answers. And yet, may we always walk trusting in our relationship with God. Amen.